I don't think Austin's going to let anybody know when, but we know it's going to happen. Austin and McMahon going to happen tonight, King, and you know it as well as I do. Here comes Tess to take on the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman, and certainly Tess and the Stephanie McMahon situation has been well documented. It was last week when Shane McMahon directed the Mean Street Posse to try and break Tess' ankle. Stephanie came out, and watch this. Shane McMahon didn't know it was his little sister and knocked his own little sister out.
Total accident. Look at the grief and compassion and Shane, on the face of Shane.
Shane had an opportunity to apologize earlier tonight, but he took the easy way out and blamed everything on Tess.
And then Shane tried to get
Joey Abs socially back together with his little sister. And here's what Stephanie said.
You keep your hands off me, and you and your friends stay the hell out of my life.
Oh, no, this is bad. Stephanie's confused.
Young and restless here.
And I'm surprised Tess can even walk around here tonight after hitting that ankle caught on that chair.
He's so clumsy.
Last week, Tess ran the gauntlet with the posse, taking on each member of the posse one at a time. It looked like Tess, after taking care of Pete Gass and Rodney, was going to take care of Joey Abs until Shane McMahon interfered. And then here came the silent assassin, Steve Blackman. You got to wonder, look at that. Tess not going to waste any time here. King, what do you think Blackman's being paid for all this dirty work?
You mean by the McMahons or by Mr. McMahon?
By Shane.
Well, I don't know the exact figure, but I'm sure it's a hefty payday.
Tess looked great last week in disposing of Rodney and then Joey Abs or Pete Gass, and it looked like Tess is going to take care of Joey Abs, but we'll never know thanks to Shane McMahon. Blackman is a strange bird, I'll tell you. He is a dangerous human being. Lethal Weapon is a great name for Steve Blackman.
Just because he shows no emotion, just because he's cool as a cucumber all the time, you think he's strange.
Well, we'll find out what he's made of. Steve Blackman, that is. Oh, my, good move there by Blackman. This Sunday at Fully Loaded in the non-sanctioned Iron Circle matchup. Challenge made by Ken Shamrock last night on Heat. A circle of cars with their lights on. The first man to leave the circle wins. Anything goes. And again, not sanctioned by the WWF as Blackman ripping at the knee of Tess in a half Boston Crab and using the ropes for an illegal advantage.
You know, I really need to. First of all, I can't see how this idiot Tess swept Stephanie off her feet. He must have used a broom the size of Alaska. But I need to talk to Stephanie. I need to sit down and have a heart to heart with her, see if I can reason with her. I can't believe that she would spurn the advances of Joey Abs after Joey tried to take her back, offered to take her back.
You've always had a way of communicating with young ladies.
Of course.
As the Irish
hit, I'm accessible, I'm open.
Takes Tess to the corner. What makes me sick about this whole thing with Shane is that Shane refuses to accept any of the responsibility for what happened last week with him and his sister. Shane wanted to blame everything on Tess.
Well, I didn't hear Shane say that.
Well, Shane's got to have everything Shane's way. Shane won't let Stephanie have her own life. I'll tell you one thing, though. I'll say this. For Tess to go through all this living hell, he must truly and sincerely care about Stephanie McMahon. Spinebuster slam. Well, I'll tell you what's still to come here tonight. The Big Show and Hardcore Holly against X-Pac and Kane. That means the Big Show and Kane are going to get it on here tonight. And what about The Undertaker and Triple H? The winner goes to Fully Loaded for the First Blood End of an Era WWF title match against the Rattlesnake.
And go ahead and say it. I know you can't wait. And Stone Cold is going to bust Mr. McMahon open. I don't think that's going to happen, JR.
Well, I'll tell you what.
You think Vince is just sitting back there right now looking at his watch thinking, oh, when am I going to get my head busted open?
He might be thinking about something along those lines.
Oh, yeah, right.
You know, Austin is a man of his word. When's the last time Austin said he was going to do something and he didn't? Yeah, there you go. Can't think of it, can you?
No, I'm watching this match. I'm trying to concentrate. Nice, I'm doing my job here.
Nice gut wrench into a power bomb by Tess. Everything's got to be Shane's way.
Hey, Shane had it tough growing up, you know.
What do you mean by that?
He had a lot of hardships.
How do you figure?
The mean streets of Greenwich. But those hardships built character.
Yeah, he got into a fight with Kathy Lee in the 12 and under line at Kroger's or something.
What?
There's a shot by Test. Was a great young athlete. Came to us as the bodyguard of Motley Crue.
Oh, yeah, that's a great recommendation. And you wonder why Shane doesn't want this goof to have anything to do with his sister. Beautiful. Way to go, baby.
Right now, the corner of his eye, saw Test with a high-risk move, and Test paid for it that time.
This guy hangs out with Motley Crue and then takes Stephanie McMahon out. Uh-uh.
Well,
what's wrong with that picture?
We saw Stephanie here earlier. She's got to be watching this match somewhere in the back on the monitor, and you got to be wondering what's going through her mind. Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute.
Yeah, the
Shane McMahon, and now the Mean Street Posse from Greenwich, Connecticut, 3-on-1 attack.
I'm sure they heard you, JR. That probably set them off when you reminded them that this goof used to be a bodyguard for Motley Crue.
These sweater vests wearing silver spoon.
Those sweater vests go through your entire wardrobe.
And look at Blackman. Blackman's done his job. The silent assassin. Now they're surveying the damage as it's a 3-on-1 attack. Martial arts weapons that Blackman's holding are called commas. And Blackman and Shamrock, it's non-sanctioned. WWF wants nothing to do with the first ever Iron Circle matchup this Sunday at Fully Loaded. It'll take place in a parking lot.
Go ahead, concrete. You got two commas going there and put the quotation marks on him.